Hey there again. It's been a long time since the last video. I'm back in Tokyo for work, but I still managed to get some days off. And today I want to talk to you about how I got out of a creative block, if you will, thanks to the Fuji X100V's ND filter, although this will not be a video about the camera itself. And an exhibition, a museum exhibition, that's how I got out of a creative block. Before I start, I have to warn you, this video is not a video praising the abilities of the X100V or the X106 at all. Everything I've done in this video, you can do it with any other camera. This one is a lot more personal and specifically about the use of ND filters in photography. So don't expect that because I really did that. I already talked about the X100V and my personal story with it. So just keep that in mind. Also, I will try to do the video here. I'm in the rooftop of the Ginza 6 building in Ginza in Tokyo, in a beautiful garden. I was amazed when I realized that I can't get here for free and have my coffee and my breakfast and enjoy the view. Over there, I think that's the one, you see the Tokyo Tower. But anyway, I digress. You see, knowing the cost of flying to Japan, I never thought that I would be able to do it again because I was here again last year. But I got lucky and we had to cover the Tokyo Motorcycle Show 2024 for my company. If you're into motorbikes, we've done videos in English, Spanish and German. You can go check them out. But once the work was done, I had this thought on the back of my head, like repeating, telling myself, like, why am I not shooting more? Why am I not doing something great? Why is everything that I shoot looking the same as before? And even when I had lunch or breakfast, I would just sat down to enjoy a coffee. I looked at the camera and I felt like the camera was staring at me and telling me, stand up, finish quickly, you have to go shoot, you only have a few days left here. So yeah, I felt like I had to finish everything as quickly as possible and get to shoot and create. And as I said, it's been raining, it's been very windy, very annoying, if you will, and that didn't help either. I did wonder why I even care about this, about taking photos or videos or filming, if I don't live from this, I don't need it. It's supposed to be a stress relief method for me, kind of therapy actually, rather than something that stressed me out. And that's exactly what it was doing. I couldn't enjoy my time here alone for the first time in years. I've never been here alone actually. And instead of that, I was just putting pressure on myself continuously. So in that mood, rainy, cold, windy Tokyo, I went to and kind of, not depressive, but you know, stressed out, Carlos, me. I went to, I think it's called Roppongi Tower. I ended up buying tickets for an exhibition at the Mori Art Museum, an exhibition I didn't plan to attend to, but I did the wrong queue, and I was facing a machine where you could only buy that ticket. I thought, I had to make some time though, so I thought, okay, let's buy it, why not? Right, and I went in. I was the first one. I was alone, and the exhibition, it was called Our Ecology, just in case you're interested. And I loved it. I loved it so much. At some points, I was like keeping my tears inside. I felt them coming up. There were some photos that, as simple as they were, they really made me stop and stare at them. There was also some sensorial kind of rooms with a floor filled with seashells where you could walk, and a dark room with a movie of a drone filming fireworks in slow motion and backwards. It was amazing. It felt like how the Big Band, you know. So I got out with a smile, totally refreshed. Also because during the exhibition, it's strictly forbidden to take photos or film. So I had no pressure. I just pulled down the camera, put it back on my backpack and forgot about it. So I went out with a new attitude. I was kind of refreshed, like not toxic anymore. and I started to embrace the rain. Like, I went out, I was walking for hours, pouring rain, and I'm taking photos of Tokyo, how Tokyo moves when it's pouring like that. Everyone is in a rush, people are running, umbrellas are crashing, tourists are crashing into each other, cars are fast, water is splashing, there's a lot of rain coming down, pouring down on you. There's so much movement when it rains here. And I realized that maybe instead of trying to freeze the moment, the scenes, that what I should do was to embrace movement. And then that came to my mind and said, hey, I've got this camera, this little camera, this here, it's me, with a built-in ND filter. And since I have the filter on top of the lens, it's also well sealed, so I don't need to worry about that. So I activated my ND filter, which, by the way, for me, it happens when you pull the lever. Now it's on. And yeah, I turned on the ND filter and thought, okay, let's try to make some slow shutter photos. My settings, by the way, are because somebody asked on Reddit and Facebook and Threads, my new favorite. It's so toxic free. I was shooting between 1/4 and 1/15, continuous focus with wide tracking, and that's about it, trying to keep it as steady as possible thanks to the strap around my neck. In this case, it would have helped a lot to have a lens that is stabilized, or having IVs like in the new X106. So my first shot, as you will see here, I don't have a lot of B-roll. I have no B-roll, so you will only be seeing photos in this video. My first shots were simple, traditional panning shots, which are fine. They do the purpose of showing movement. If you nail focus, they look great, but they're easy to miss. The trick, in my experience, to be perpendicular to the subject, so there's no, it doesn't get closer or farther to from you as much as you can get perpendicular to a fast moving car. But then I thought, okay, these are not the photos that I will remember in 10 years. They are not special. So what else doesn't move quickly in Tokyo? They came to my mind, people. People move very quick. They want to run through the streets. They jaywalk. They're moving their umbrellas. You know, you don't want to get wet as I was. I was soaked. I did several experiments before I got something that I liked. I had this bunch of people waiting at the crossing, the zebra, and I tried to show those figures, silhouette somehow. Didn't quite work. I will show you some photos. I will also show you the fails. Why not? I tried tracking people running from one side to another. That didn't quite work out either. And then I saw, you know, here in Tokyo, the zebra lines on the road, they're really large, they're very long. So I thought, okay, maybe I can use those together with some human shape. And then I shot this one with a red umbrella. It's a girl on a red umbrella. And this one I really love. I can't explain why. I don't get why I love this picture. I don't know if it's because of the red color mixing with the lines, or just maybe because you can tell exactly what's going on in this scene, even though it's completely blurry. But I like it. I don't know about your opinion. If you like it, please let me know, because I found it quite irrational to like this one. I got another opportunity when a man stopped next to me, put his back down, and there was nobody else. And usually I would have shot him, that silhouette, right? But I thought, okay, now let's keep the same style, the same techniques. And I tried and failed many times to get his silhouette in front of a car moving. Did many shots, failed many shots, but there's this one, the one that you're seeing right now, that turned out pretty good. That's exactly what I wanted. I like it. I really like it. But if I could change something, it's a car that I shot. I would have liked to have some of the more Japanese cars, more charismatic cars that they have here, a key car or a taxi or something like that. But I still like it. So because I got that with a car that I didn't like, the subject I didn't like that much, next was to look for a subject that I could like more, like a taxi, right? And so I did that. I went to the next crossing, and there was a bunch of people, like 20, 30, 50 people, a lot of people waiting this time. And it was really hard to focus on a car moving when there were so many people in front of you. But I still tried. So what I did was to track focus the cars that were coming, and then continue panning in burst mode. And this is the result. I don't know if you can tell, I think this is shot in 1/4, so it's a very slow shutter for a camera with no IBIS. But there's a bunch of people, like a lot of people in front of this car. I will show you also the one that I posted on Instagram, but also the ones that I did not post on Instagram or anywhere that, but I would consider the less good photos. So you can see that, yeah, everyone fails. Especially me. Then I was closer to home, really my hotel here in Ginza. Not my favorite place though. It was most convenient for work. I was walking towards the hotel, and you know, here in Ginza there are these alleys with a very, very high skyscrapers, very high buildings. So you've got a very narrow alley and very high buildings next to it. So I thought, all right, so what happens if I pan vertically? And that's how I got these shots. I was trying to get the subjects in the middle of the frame and use the verticality of the buildings as some sort of frame for those subjects. I don't know if it really worked out as I wanted, because I didn't try that much. Probably I should have stayed there and tried to get the subjects in the middle and or clean a bit the photo in Photoshop. But I did that. I was happy enough with it. Those photos really put me in a complete different mood, because I saw that I could take it a lot slower. I could still enjoy my life. The little moments, the coffees and the rain. And at the same time, find that way where photography is a stress relief rather than stressing me out. And next day, maybe because of destiny or whatever, it was sunny and warm, 16, 17 degrees. I went to Nakameguro, one of my favorite spots here. Super chill area, just walking around. And I couldn't stop staring at the trees. Here in Tokyo, you will find the gardens everywhere, in every corner. Everything has been taken care of to the minimum. Like every single detail is perfect in those gardens, everything. You see trees in every house. It's amazing how the representation that nature has in such a huge city like Tokyo. And so I couldn't stop staring at those trees with the wind moving the branches and the leaves. And I took some photos, regular photos, some videos, regular videos. And then I thought, okay, I could actually use again the same technique, use the ND filter without panning this time to show how much those trees are moving. Because when I take the photo with a fast shutter speed, you don't see any movement. You don't actually know that it's been moving. And so I did. I'm very happy with this one. I like the contrast and how messy the tree got. And I kept walking and I reached this point in Shibuya where there's a lines of cherry blossoms. The ones that I left, because most of them were gone. And there I tried again. There was these trees wrapping around a lamppost. And I thought, all right, so what if I could use the ND filter again to show the movement of those flowers around the lamppost? And the lamppost stays stationary. Tried, failed completely. The tree wouldn't move enough. And yeah, it didn't work. I would have needed a tripod like I'm using right now, or if not a tripod, IVs at least, to reach that effect. It did not work. But I was very happy with my my other photo, the one, the regular photo that I took, which I'm showing you right now, together with a few more, because why not? I didn't expect to see any cherry blossom, because I knew that there had been some storms passing by Tokyo, and they were mostly gone. But yeah, I took so many photos together with dozens of tourists and girls doing selfies shamelessly. I spent so much time there. But yeah, I'm happy with the photos that I eventually used and posted. And I know now that in that case, if I were to use an ND filter, I would have probably needed a tripod or a eyepiece, a camera with eyepiece, to get the result that I wanted. I would probably shoot again with an ND filter, but this time with a camera that I'm using to film, the X-H2, which has an eyepiece. And I will also use the ND filter that I'm using now to film myself, so probably I will repeat some of those shots. Anyway, long story short, if it happens to you, what happened to me, where you've got these clouds in your head and you don't know what to do to get rid of them, because you don't even know where they come from. You don't know why you're grumpy or why you're angry. And then I would recommend to you, in my case, it was art, what put me in another mood, and the fact that I was exploring areas where I had never been to before. Yeah, so I would recommend probably museums. They're a great help, exhibitions, galleries. There's such a strong source of inspiration. And the other thing that I really like, and I do it even at home when I can, is just walking somewhere I don't know. Because it takes you out of that autopilot mode that you find yourself at on every day. And I guess you're using your brain a different way. To me, it worked, and it made me use my camera for what I'm supposed to use it for, to create something I'm happy with and to be happy while I do. Yeah, I think that's it for now. Thank you for watching. And again, you can find me, DM me on Instagram, wherever. I'm happy to talk to people. Always. Thank you again. Yeah. Come to Tokyo. It's an amazing city. I love this country. I love it. I just wish I could speak some Japanese. Bye.